Hi everyone, my name is Deborah Stine. I am a professor of the practice in engineering and public policy and associate director for policy outreach at the Scott Institute for Energy Innovation at Carnegie Mellon University. Welcome to this lecture answering the question, how should you summarize your policy analysis? In this lecture, we'll explore the steps you should use in summarizing your policy analysis, describe the key questions you should ask yourself as you finalize your recommendations, and identify methods to disseminate your message to policymakers.
This video will provide you with guidance as to how to conduct Step 8 of the Bardock 8-step process for policy analysis. In it, you'll learn how to tell your story. You've done a great deal of work at this point to make sure your analysis is a good one. However, if you don't do a good job telling your story, no one will listen. Imagine you're a policymaker. You're in charge of many topics, and a large report hits your desk. It's late at night, you're already tired, and yet here is another document to read and think about. You yawn and start to read. But as the text gets more and more boring, you set it aside and you say you'll get to it tomorrow. But of course you never do, as yet a new report arrives on a different topic on your desk the following morning. Policymakers are not that different from you when you face a stack of reading for a class. So the key is to make your report interesting by telling a story with a beginning, middle, and end. And by bringing new analysis and thought to a topic, as opposed to just expressing opinion without analysis or data, as is often the case in policy. So what are some of the key principles in presenting a policy analysis? First, policy analysis is not a cookbook exercise, and there are no absolute right or wrong answers. It's more of an art than a science. So when you tell your story, your goal is not to show all the work you've done step by step, but instead to provide your analysis in an interesting way, such that a reader can understand your thinking and on the analysis on which it is based. Second, recognize your personal biases and that of any analysis you incorporate into your analysis. Read over your report and watch for creeping advocacy in your analysis. If you use a source of information that is from a non-governmental organization or a firm with a particular point of view, be sure to point that point of view out in your report. You can find this by looking at the mission statement of the organization who provided the analysis. Third, be neutral in your analysis of a situation. The analysis is what it is. Don't be tempted to make it lean one side or another. Fourth, keep the client in mind at all times, as that influences problem definition, actions within their jurisdiction, and budget. When you're reviewing your report, make sure that what you propose is something the client can actually do. Otherwise, the report is not very useful for them, and they will set it aside. When a report is completed, you're only halfway done if your goal is to influence policymakers. A common mistake is for a report to be released once and then move on to the next. However, if you do that, you'll have little impact. You need to continue telling your story in multiple venues. And finally, credibility is key for both you and the organization for whom you work and your client. Check all calculations and cite all numbers. Make sure your report is well documented and contains no plagiarism. In writing the summary of your analysis, you need to go through the following steps, including identifying what are the three policy options you identified, which of the four E's criterion, if any, are most important in addressing your problem. As a reminder, those are effectiveness, efficiency, equity, and ease of political acceptability. And all these were described in an earlier video. Third, what are the pros and cons associated with the four E's? Both the policy you're recommending and the ones you do not recommend. And finally, what are some options for overcoming the cons for the policy options you did select? Here's an example of a few paragraphs from a summary section. Stop the video for a moment and read over it. Keep in mind that the reader may only read the executive summary located at the beginning or the summary section located at the end. Reports today are often not read from beginning to end, but instead sampled with a focus on the key messages and the more in-depth reading if the results are of interest. Note that in the first paragraph here, we've described our options to a question which is addressing concerns about the cost of parking on a university campus. Next, the goal is to go through each of the four E's and synthesize together the results of your analysis. For this paragraph, focused on effectiveness, we're summarizing the pros and cons of the different options and saying in the first sentence which option makes the most sense based solely on the criteria. Here is an example of a final recommendation paragraph. Stop the video and read it over. This paragraph brings together the summary analysis of all four E's, including the con for the recommended policy option, and action to respond to that concern. That will help the policymaker address this concern when those objecting to the recommended policy bring it up during discussions. In telling your story, keep these principles from Bardock's Eightfold Policy Path book in mind. First, apply what he calls the Grandma Bessie test. That is, explain your key messages to a regular person not involved with the topic. Say an older relative who's interested in what you're doing but does not know any technical jargon. Second, gauge your audience. Do they want a little detail, a lot of detail, graphics? Think about what information is most important to them and how the information is best presented. Other key principles are communicating clearly, giving your story logical flow, and most importantly, not using your analysis steps as a way of telling the story, a common mistake. What you prepare for your own use is not the same as how you present it to others. And finally, don't interrupt the argument flow by discussing the uncertainties. Instead, use softening words like may, might, could, etc. As mentioned earlier, there is no recipe or right answer. We cannot predict the future, and conditions might change as well, leading to a change in what you would recommend. So avoid declarations that one policy is the only right one for a situation. Next, consider what medium to use to communicate your message. Should it be written, oral, PowerPoint or video, short or long? Should you combine a number of these and produce multiple products and use multiple options for dissemination? And when you release your report, should you have a press briefing, which is typically press only, which few reports deserve, or a public briefing that brings together not only press, but stakeholders interested in the issue? And how should you use social media to attract an audience to your briefing and to disseminate your report to those who cannot attend an event? Should you have endorsers or validators at your briefing representing key stakeholders to show they support your report? And should you video webcast your public event so that others can see it at a later date? This dissemination strategy is important to consider well before your event for the optimal press coverage and related public discussion for it. Just putting up on a website and expecting others to find it is insufficient for getting out your message. So it is important to develop a long-term dissemination plan. Identify the key actors that are likely to support or oppose your recommendations, and perhaps consider briefing them prior to the public briefing. Consider the political environment. When will decisions related to your report need to be made? And then who will make them? Those are other people to consider for pre-briefings. And think about the timing of the release and critical decisions. It's no good issuing a report a month after a decision has been made on the topic of it. To conclude, summarize your analysis based on consideration of the criteria, pros and cons. Don't jump to whatever your favorite recommendation is, but instead base your recommendation on a neutral analysis of the situation, setting aside any personal biases. Next, the summary of your analysis should focus on what the policymaker needs to know. Extra information is generally not welcome in the limited time maker policymakers will have to read your report. Don't tell them what they already know. And finally, develop a long-term dissemination plan so that your report can have the maximum impact.
Thank you for watching, and I encourage you to watch the other videos in this series.